In 1946, the Federal Bureau of Investigation closed its headquarters office in Mississippi and divided responsibility of covering the state between FBI New Orleans and FBI Memphis. However, as violence increased during the civil rights struggle, the agency returned 18 years later.
So we still, I think, as you know, look at the hate crimes, but we also look at domestic terrorism and domestic terrorism groups, extremist groups. So we still have white supremacist groups out there. We still have militia groups out there.
Deputy Director Mark Giuliano delivers the keynote address to commemorate the reopening of the FBI's permanent headquarters in Jackson. 50 years ago on this day, the FBI moved into Mississippi after one of the most heinous hate crimes ever committed in the state. That was the murder of civil rights workers Michael Schwerner, James Cheney, and Andrew Goodman. A year earlier, civil rights activist Medgar Evers was gunned down at his home. His widow, Merle Evers Williams, has become a civil rights leader herself. And after 50 years of fighting against wrong and trying to move Mississippi forward, she's not done.
Say, I don't care how tired you are, you can't sit, because the monster of race and racism and hatred, it's still there, and it's still within our boundaries.
Because of the political partisan strife that we're seeing, I think it has caused some problems for us moving forward. But I think people will regain their footing, and I think we'll continue to move forward, as a couple of speakers mentioned today.
State Attorney General Jim Hood was on the panel, along with former Governor William Winter. Reverend James Young, who delivered the invocation to open the event, is mayor of Philadelphia, the city at the heart of the so-called Mississippi Burning Murders. Young was the first African American to integrate his school.
My parents didn't teach us to be think inferior, so I just felt like these were just white kids. They just happened to be white. I just happened to be black, and that's about the way it was. No traumatic incidents at all.
Young says that it's because of the sacrifices of civil rights volunteers and the efforts of the FBI to control lawlessness when Mississippi law enforcement failed that he's able to be mayor today. At FBI headquarters in Jackson, Woodrow Wilkins, WXVT, Delta News.
Anyway, we've come so far.